Let's try that again, but with a more proactive attitude. Now, do you see the difference between fighting the odds and just moping about?
Mr. Cornet, say something!
Brussels is the capital of Belgium?
Ugh, I do not mope!
Sorry, Claire. I was hoping you'd bump into me for dramatic effect, but I didn't count on how small I was, and bleh. Anyway, what I wanted to say was, let them help you.
But they seem really bad at helping.
Oh, they are. But they're even worse when they don't get their own way.
She disappeared!
No, I've just gone around the corner for dramatic effect.
So now it was time for the hardest goodbye of all. Jared, the love of
my...
Jared, you've got to trust us.
You have to follow Claire to Detroit, okay?
But not straight away.
Let her get all the way to the airport. Then, as she waits to board the plane, and the last call for the flight is announced, you run through the airport in slow motion. You grab her hand. She sees the bracelet. The bracelet she made for you is a symbol of your love.
Sorry, do I know you?
Listen, this is not a story with a happy ending, okay? It's a story I write in my diary using my tears as ink.
You think you live in some amazing magic wonderland where everything has a happy ending?
Well, the truth is, this is real life.
And bad things happen in real life.
Why so sad?
Wait a minute. This here is a talking, dancing banana who somehow has a butt. We're in a school with a T-Rex, a ghost, a toast, and whatever Principal Brown is. Now who dares to say this world isn't amazing? The world is what you make it!
But she doesn't want our help.
Do you want to be a spectator in life, or do you want to play a part?
Wasn't this about helping Claire?
Yeah, the two. Now let's go and give her a happy ending, whether she likes it or not!
Wait, why do I have a butt?
My eyes dropped pearls of sadness as I saw my past drift away into nothingness. I saw the swings where Wilson and I shared so much. The park where Jared...
Stop the bus! We mentioned everything! Stop the bus!
Where Jared gave his heart to me. The picket fences on the streets. Streets I walked 1,000 times. Our old house. Its for sale sign mocking me from the front lawn. I looked at my friends' houses. Houses in which I'd never again laugh. In which I'd never again cry. But what have I gained by this loss? And what does that mean? Maybe it doesn't mean anything. Anything at all. The only thing left to do is stare at the rain. So I guess this is it. Goodbye, Elmore. Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, life.
Just go with it. These people are insane.
Take that!